Hello everybody, welcome back to Sharkom 2023. We have a great run here by Seasoner.
Hello.
Coming up. Hello Seasoner, how are you?
Well, I would say I am tired, but that represents me basically every hour of every day. So, welcome to...
That's fair enough. It's all good. But what are you going to be running today?
I shall be running Virtue's Last Reward. This is an escape room themed visual novel where I will be skipping all of the story because otherwise this run is about 8 hours.
Alright. Well, I hope we have a good one. People, if you don't know, the Sharkom 2023 is a charity stream. We're raising money for the Trevor Project. We've got $90 raised already, so, you know, let's go. Hope to see more donations coming in as the runs go on. And I hope we have a good run ahead of us and hope everything goes smooth. Thank you for all of the organizers, hosts, restreamers, everything as well, all the runners. And let's get into this run.
So I'm going to exit this options menu, and then there's going to be a main menu like this. But I can't stay on it too long, otherwise it goes to a demo movie. So when I press start from the beginning, that's when the time starts. So 3, 2, 1, and go.
Good luck.
Thank you. So in this run, I said we're skipping all of the story and we're only doing the escape rooms. And there are how many of them? Like 20 or so? Something like that. This first one is, so we start off in this like elevator. What am I doing? You might, I'm gonna be concentrating for quite a lot of this, I apologize.
You're all good. We can go ahead and read out like donations when those happen. Read out chat if anything interesting pops up. Maybe someone has a question about the game.
So the first thing I will note is that anyone who's played this game casually knows that some of these puzzles are actually quite difficult. We don't have to do all of the puzzles. We just have to do as much as is required, as little as required to get the safe passwords.
I think I've seen this game been played before, but for people that don't know, what sort of a genre is this? Is it like puzzle? Would you say?
It's a escape room themed visual novel.
Okay.
So, for example, if anyone who's familiar with Phoenix Wright will know that that centers around like courtrooms and all that kind of stuff. This focuses more around the escape rooms and solving all the puzzles to get to the point where the story gets told to you. Thank you. that password is Moon Moon Star. I actually have to remember that for the end of the game. And my memory is not good enough to have that for an hour, so I'm for 2 hours, so I'm gonna have to write that down. Now, annoyingly, for the sections in between the escape rooms, I just press a button and the text goes at a predetermined speed. But in the escape rooms, that doesn't happen. So in order to have the text go along, I have to actually mash it. So the speed I mash determines how quickly this goes. That was 2, 3, not 4. 3 and 6 star. I have to keep that for later on. So now we're out, so as far as the story goes, we're now out of our room that we started in. We get introduced to everyone else, a wide, varied cast of characters, all ages, genders, etc. We find out we're stuck, we find out the rules, we get to know each other a little bit, and then these doors, these coloured doors, don't open. Except they eventually do open after a set amount of time, and you have to choose who goes in which door based on colour theory. You have to match your colours. And I think it's light colour theory, which means it's redactive rather than additive or whatever, I don't understand. Well, I just know there are certain colours and... everyone has a bracelet on their wrist, the bracelet has a colour, and you have to match the colours. I'm going into the yellow door first. When the doors open, you have to choose who goes in what room, and and after 5 minutes the door closes. If you're not in the room, you die. What am I doing first? Hit the button first. This girl on the left, her name is Fi. You'll see her a lot. She's in quite a lot of these. Star again. Now the passwords are different in every save file, but luckily I only have to actively remember that, write down that first one, because that's the only one that gets used more than once. Because it gets used again right at the end. Chat or what, if anyone watching is aware of the prisoner's dilemma, that's how this game gets from point A to point B. So at the end of every room, every escape room, every round, there is something called the AB game, which functions very similar to the prisoner's dilemma. You can either betray an ally with your the person you're playing with, because it's a pair in a solo, 2-on-1. You can either ally with them or you can betray them. Everyone starts with 3 points. If both people ally, everyone gets 2 points. If one allies and one betrays, the betrayer gets 3, and the person who allies loses 2. And if everyone betrays, no one gets or loses any points. And the idea is you want to get to 9. That gets explained here. Fire is currently explaining that to us. So what we're going to do in this first room, is this first section, is we're going to ally and we're going to get betrayed. Which leaves us with, this leaves both us, we are Sigma, and Phi, the girl, we both now only have 1 point. So if any of us ally again and get betrayed again, we would go into negative points and we would die. This section, where we see, this goes very quickly, but if you saw the stills of him in the car and getting hit by the gas, we see that a lot. Because that happens after every first round, so you see that 3 times. And after all 3 of those, you go into each of the 3 rooms that each of the teams went into, and they have little discussions about what they found and all the rest of it. For 2 of them, the room order is important, such as this first one. Because the 3 rooms are the lounge, the crew quarters, and the infirmary. We want to go into the infirmary last, because there is a scene that happens there involving one of the characters. And if we went into the infirmary second, or we didn't go into the infirmary last, it'd have to be someone would come into the room we were in and tell us to go to the infirmary to watch the scene, which is slow. And that happens again. There's a second time in which it happens again, but it happens from a different door. Now the second one, there are coloured doors again, but the coloured doors are different because the colours were different. We go into the red door and we end up with these 2 characters. We go in, this is one of despite this being, I think, only the second escape rather than the third escape room, this is one of the more technical ones. So I'm probably not going to be saying much for the next, 2 minutes.
A biology lesson going on here.
Yeah, I mean, this is a lab. Remember, in the last round, I allied and got betrayed, so I'm currently only at one point. If I ally again and get betrayed again, I die. Well, what that thing I just had, that purple medicine, one of the characters is unwell, and it was found that the thing I just got cures his illness. Well, if you've been able to pay attention, this person in the hat takes that medicine and tells us that the only way to get it back is for us to ally in this next round, essentially killing ourselves. So we have to do that. And he also said we can't tell anyone that we found the medicine in that room either, because if we either told anyone we found it, or if we betrayed him in this upcoming round, he would throw it, throw the medicine on the floor, breaking the glass, and obviously rendering it completely useless. One of the first times we find out this guy, his name is Dio, is a little bit of an asshole. So we ally again, we get betrayed again. We don't actually find out that we get betrayed again here, because I'm actually leaving before we get to that point. Oh, come on. There we go. Where am I going now? Going up here. So we gained information. We gained information in that section that will help us in other routes along the game, but we don't actually have to reach the end point of that of the route to be able to use that information. We just have to get outside of the room after the voting, which is why we immediately leave. But we need that information. We need the information because it gives us two very useful things that will come up later. To start again, because I accidentally double tapped. Is that right? No, I can't count correctly. What? One. Nine. Oh, yeah. I can't count. It's fine. I can't do very simple mathematics. That room is a lot more difficult. Oh, there are a lot more elements to it if you play this casually. You have to call each person, because there are four rooms in that section. You have to call all of the rooms. They give you the other two girls that I'm with. They give you information. That's how you. But if you know how to get the information, you just do it. You don't have to actually like do any of that. The only thing you're not allowed to do in this game really is essentially start from a new game plus file and just input the passwords into the safe immediately. That's the only thing you're not really allowed to do. Something like this is a lengthy section coming up. This all skip. This is a re-release. This game was originally released on the 3DS, and the all skip function didn't exist in that version. In the original 3DS version, you have to listen to all of the dialogue at least once, and only once you've listened to a line of dialogue already are you allowed to skip it. But for the re-release, they just changed it, so you can skip all of the dialogue. Which makes this a lot easier. We are betraying Alice here. So, it might come up too quickly to notice, but there are three... potential. But the first round, we can go to three different doors. I think it's magenta, cyan, and yellow. I think that's right. And each one, you end up with a different person. You can either go with Alice, which we just did, who we just betrayed. You can go with Hemioji, who we went with in the first room, where we allied and he betrayed us. And in the third room, which we haven't been into yet, we go with a character called Luna. Of those three, the only one whose vote is consistent is Luna. When you're paired with Temioji, he always goes opposite you. So if you ally, he betrays you. And if you betray, he will ally. And it's the same with Alice. So that round, I pressed betray, she allied, so I betrayed her. But if I pressed ally, she would betray me. The only one who doesn't do that is Luna. She will always ally. If you either ally or betray her, she will always ally. Now, if you notice, this time round, I did the rooms in a slightly different order. I don't know if you did, but I did the rooms in a slightly different order. Because in this room, I don't know why I'm pointing, you can't see me. But in this room, there is something important that just got found. We found a bomb. And if we were in a different room of the three, went into that, if we were in a different of those three rooms last, we'd have a character come into that room and tell us to go to the crew quarters to see the bomb. That's how I felt about that. Yes, that's fine. So we end up in the red room again. In both round two so far, we've gone into the red room and we're with Fi again.
Real quick, if you're not...
Oh, if you have a donation, do it.
Yeah. Donation, $5 from da_Tims for the Trevor Project. Says, happy to donate to a good cause. Thanks everyone for a great marathon thus far. Thank you very much for the $5, Tims. We are at 95 out of 330 goal. But every dollar counts, so thank you very much to everyone who's donated thus far, viewed, shared, whatever you can to help the marathon out. And yeah, hope Sharkom 2023, we can raise as much money as we can. So yeah.
This run is probably... this was released on PS4. I'm playing it on PC. And if you play it on PC, it's a lot easier. Because if you play it on PC, you can skip a 30. You can skip this dialogue we have to mash. You can just bind it to the mouse wheel. So you can just endlessly just do that instead of having to mash buttons. Come on, I didn't want to examine this. Hurry up. 7, which is that one. 2, 1, 3. That one's easy, because this is the backwards L. Oh, I'd examined it again. So each of these rooms actually has 2 passwords. We don't get any of the second passwords because we don't need them. That's a different category completely. I think that's a 100% thing, because you don't need any of them. They only give you, they're called gold files, which is just like additional lore and stuff like that. And normally you have to solve the final puzzle in the room in a different way to get the second password. One of the gates has been opened, the voting rooms. That's always Dio, because he's an asshole. The boy is still ill. Oh, and this one, I think the boy got ill while they were in the room. And I'm glad that we can skip this, because the voice is really shrill, and as a small child, he tries to stab himself a lot, which is kind of like Monka-esque. the child got ill. He was trying to stab himself with a scalpel. Then another woman tried to do the same. She ran off, and we were running all around the rooms to find her. We found her. She's fine. She's alive. But now we don't have long until the voting ends. And in this route, we betrayed in round 1. So if we betray again in round 2, we get to 9 points, and we can leave. Which is what we do. So we betrayed. And that was an error. We got the game over. Oh no. That's the first. Oh. Yeah, that's a required game over. Even in, no matter what category you do, that is a required game over. Because it gives you a piece of information that you use when you ally and get betrayed. Which one's my picking up? Thomas, blue. Green. Red. I never remember which way around, which order these are in. The only problem with having to mash is that sometimes I end up examining the key by mistake. Going through this again. Everyone's been through the first room. They've found the second. They found the second set of doors that don't open. The rules of the game are being explained again. We found a woman. A woman. That woman is very important, but I won't say anything. I hope I don't say anything because that is. One of the key parts of the element, the key things of this, the plot of this game, which is very important. So in this game, we are betraying Luna. We're betraying the really, really friendly and nice person. Because we're not friendly and nice people. So we've now been through all three round one games. So this is the last time we get to see this scene of the car and. Wait, come on, there we go. With him in the car. Get to see this for the last time. This happens for the last time as well, which I'm glad about. This is the only one of the three where the order does not matter, because neither of the two things that cause the necessary room order happen in this path. The kid doesn't get ill yet, and we don't find bombs. In this run, we don't have a choice. We go through the red door because we betrayed Luna. and other things conspire so that everyone says no to the other two paths, we have to go to the red door. And now we are in a pantry. Shelf falls out. Oh, I think I screwed it up. Whoops. Yeah, I screwed that up. Oh well, I got it on the second try. I lost where I was. Because with that one, since I'm reading the notes as to where I am, I have to, like, play it by audio cues.
Out of curiosity, have you played Danganronpa?
I actually haven't.
Oh, okay.
But that's another one of those where if I did, I would do it. Give me just 1 second. Yeah, the Danganronpa is another one of those where I've seen people play them, so I know how the story goes. So yeah, but if I did play them, I'd probably do it as either speedruns or I'd play them once, using a guide to max out the friendship, whatever they're called.
Yeah.
Yeah, those two series are so, like, it's like 1A, or not say 1A, 1B, but they're made by the same developer, they reference each other all the time.
Yeah, they have very similar vibes, just looking at, like, the gameplay. And also, we got a donation from Dysfunctional Raps, hitting $15 to the Trevor Project. Thank you very much for that donation. And with that, we have passed the $100 threshold. We are now at 110. Let's go.
I have a controller in my hands, but I am clapping on the inside.
I'll clap for you. Discord probably can't pick that up, but okay.
I looked at the wrong part of things. That. Yeah, I know. Boomer recognizes Boomer. It's fine. Did I do all 5 of these? I think I did. 3. Yeah, I did all 5. Insert the tray back into the bucket. Goes ding. The bucket's going next. Yes, I know. Wait, have I done this wrong? No, it's just not working. There we go. That was silly. I think I will say that people are able to appreciate, even though I'm not really doing much of this as intended, is how much the soundtrack of this game just completely slaps. At least in my opinion, this game soundtrack slaps. Oh no, people are dead. So yeah, because we betrayed Luna in round one, and we were paired with Alice, who's one of the dead people, against Clover. And we just betrayed Clover, so now we're at 9 points, and we're leaving. And luckily, two other people are also leaving with us. We have Fi, who's basically joined to the hip. Joined to us by at the hip for most of this. And then we have Dio. The three of us escaped. Well, the two of them escaped together because they were in the same pair, and we escaped alongside them, but through separate votes. And there we go, we're at the end. Sort of, not really. There's another hour and a half left. But the first time you see the credits, you can't skip it. Even in the re-release on PC, I can't skip this. So enjoy, I don't know, what, so like 2.5 minutes of credits?
What's your favorite credit name? There's one just called K, just K.
Yeah, is the name of one of the characters.
W name, just K.
So the nine, okay, let me see if I can remember all of the characters, all of the characters' names. Sigma, Phi, and Alice. Temioji, Quark, and Luna. So that leaves Clover, Dio, and K. I think I did I repeat any of them? I don't think I did. But those are the nine characters.
Those are so anime.
I mean, this is a Japanese game.
It makes sense. O only one person on music. They compose this whole soundtrack. Incredible.
Yeah, and you know, that each, so there are 9 endings in this game, each of which is associated with one of the characters. And in each, for the most part, in each case, within that character's ending, you learn about their backstory. And we skipped it all, but this is Dio's ending. So we, you know, if I had skipped it, we'd have learned a lot about who he is and his motives and all of that kind of stuff. And his, so in this game, you get information that you have to use on other paths. Dio's ending, I think, is one of 2. I think it's 2 or 3, but it's one. Is it the 1 of 2 or 1 of 3? I can't remember. But you don't have to have any information from other routes to do this one. You can do this one immediately. Andorra, which is that one. And we are allying
Dio
with ours to get betrayed. We are now getting betrayed by Alice. Oh yeah, I forgot. It's actually, you see this 6 times, not 3, I'm an idiot. After betraying and allying every time. Oh no, I just lied on the internet. Da-da-da-da-da. The crew quarters, the one you want to be in here, because this is the, because we went with Alice, this is going to be a route where we find a bomb. Yeah, here's the bomb. And what do bombs do? Bombs go boom. This conversation is them talking about how the bomb works and how much power the bomb has. And how certain people know certain pieces of information, and the fact that they won't tell you why they know. It all gets explained at the end, and I won't explain it because I actually want people to enjoy this game. Or play this game for themselves. In this one, because we got betrayed, there were 2 people with only 1 point, 1 BP. So they got to choose what they wanted, and therefore, which door was it that was forced? I think it's blue. Blue door is forced, and we're now into the botanical garden. I can't just move from place to place after she hit the arrows. Stops the waterfall. I skipped it, but there's a great line of dialogue there where you interact with the pepper, and Sigma goes, "Oh look, it's a paprika." And then Luna's just like, "No, that's a pepper, you fool." Yes, indeed. Paprika.
Spelling is hard.
It's on a map. It's another thing. So there's a conversation that happens here that's a reference to the first game in the series, which I think, which if you play both games and you see that conversation, it's very funny. About her composition. And by that I don't mean how much of her breasts are on show. He's ill again, the kid's ill again, we find out the illness he actually has, this scene again. She's ill again. And she's alive. She's not always alive. Well, in this particular path, she is always alive. But you don't always find her alive. In certain paths, she is unfortunately dead. So, if we hadn't done the thing where we went into the laboratory and got betrayed by Dio, we wouldn't be able to progress past this point. We've got information from that path that allows us to progress here. And there was a point there where it was talked about, Sigma, how do you know this? That happens a lot. So we actually betray Alice here. Despite the fact that she is currently in a hospital bed because she's ill, we betray her. Luna's all upset, and turns out Alice actually betrayed us. So if we'd have allied, thinking she was in hospital, she'd have killed us. She gets all sad because she's like, I could have killed you. We find out more about her, why she's involved in all of this. And it turns out that we have the code, a certain code necessary to do something. We knew some numbers that allows her to decode a secret message. Which is this. A and now we needed information gained from the path where we escaped with Dio and Fi. Otherwise we'd have been stuck there as well. That would have been a point where we were stuck. We find out information about Dio here. Or everyone else finds out information about Dio. Because we trick him into giving stuff away. He gives us the deactivation code for one of the bombs we saw, and we explode. yellow door. Oh, there. And now we betray Temmyoji. Previously, we allied with him and he betrayed us. Now we're betraying, and it turns out that he allied. So our decisions are affecting his decisions. Very timey-wimey multiverse hoo-ha. For this one, the order is important. There are no bombs, which means we choose this one next, and the kid gets ill before the second round, so we have to choose the infirmary last. Otherwise, we get slowed down. We pick the slow option. And we don't want to be going slow. This old guy that we were just talking with, he gets annoyed at us, doesn't really want to talk to us about much, considering we just betrayed him. But then we find the kid collapsed in the infirmary, and this scene happens again. But Alice is cognizant, and she's aware and healthy this time. Because we betrayed Temmyoji, certain other things also happened. The green door is forced on us. We go into this treatment center, and we're actually taking the kid with us. So it's just Sigma, Clover, and Quark is the name of the kid. And he's completely useless to us in this room because he's collapsed. He's unwell. We take this. Examine it. Because we don't actually have to do any of the puzzles in this room, we can just put the password in straight away. Moon, moon, moon. Oh, the safe is right there. The door's... I was going towards the door, not the safe. I got ahead of myself. An injection gun. Come on, Clover, hurry up. There's another map. Key cards. Additional rules. And the key. I'm gonna have to do a ton more mashing now because the quickest way is just to do the tablet and just put the password in immediately. But it means that we didn't end up in the part of the room with the pods and because it's a treatment pods, treatment center. We didn't end up doing this, so it happens just before we leave, which means I have to mash. But mashing is actually quite difficult. Thank you. done with the mashing for now. Yeah, we put the kid in a pod to rest. This is where we tell everyone. No one found anything. No one found any of the necessary treatment. So, because we betrayed in round one, if we betrayed here, we'd have enough to leave. And Clover tries to seduce us into making that decision, into betraying the kid. But if we betray him, we get a game over because they associate, because they think that we're a bit of a prick for betraying the kid. So they stop us from leaving, and Clover just leaves on her own, and you get a game over. But if you ally, you don't get enough points to leave, so we get all of this. I mean, this is all this is Clover's backstory. I was unwell, we have to run after her, we went into every single room, didn't find her. We go into the infirmary, and everyone's dead. Everyone died. I went into door one, which is that one. Okay, so now we've gone to this other path, and we're now allying with Luna. After the room where I did the things with the alcohol, now I'm allying with Luna. As I said, she's the only one whose vote doesn't change. So we allied with her, she allies with us. She presses ally, even if we betray her. There's no switch like there is with the other two. Okay, so I think this is the last time we see this little cutscene with the smoke in the car. Because I've now allied and betrayed on all three paths. And at this one, the room order doesn't matter because he's not ill. It's not ill yet, and we don't find bombs. Alice is annoyed because she got betrayed, so she's trying to force decisions upon us. The kid is now not feeling very well. We go through the blue door. Now, I'm actually going to do something additional in this room. There's something that isn't part of the actual solving of the puzzle in the speedrun, but it's done casually, but I'm just gonna do it because I think it's hilarious. Come on. Yes, what? Oh. I think I have, because I have to do it this way around, I forgot. Okay, now press the button. Which we now use, I think, here. And the thing I'm not normally expected to do is put a coin into this machine. Because doing it gives you this! Look at this, look at how cute this is! Look at the armored guy just on the ride. Look at how cute it is. That's not required in it. It's so goofy, but it's so brilliant. And it's not required to solve this room in any way.
Oh, you did it to flex.
I did it because it's really funny.
You had to show it.
Yeah, of course I did.
There's no way. Nice. I like it.
If you're playing it casually, you are supposed to do it because it gives you the clue for this puzzle I'm about to do. Just for the record, this is what the picture looks like. I can't really zoom in further, but that's what the picture looks like. I need to move this. We've just played pool, and now we're playing darts. Okay, so we immediately leave the room. Turns out someone opened one of the door. AB rooms. Of course, it's Dio. I don't remember what happens here. Where is everyone? People dead here? Is Alice dead here? Yeah, Alice and Luna are dead. So because we allied with Luna, we have 5 points. Whereas I believe Kay betrayed in the first round, so he is at 6. So we actually have to betray here, because otherwise he would betray us, and he would get to 9 and he would leave, which is a game over. So we have to betray him. He betrays us, he doesn't get any points, it stops him from leaving. So the game can continue. If you saw, like, the one frame. someone did get to 9 points. But that was Quark. That was the kid who is unable to do, who can't move. He's in a hospital. Like, he's in a hospital with, under the effects of anesthesia. He cannot move. So him getting to 9 is not particularly worrying for any of the other players. There's the kid, and he has no bracelet. Someone's taken his bracelet off. And the only way for the bracelet to come off is to escape or for your heartbeat to drop to zero. Which means someone dropped his heartbeat to zero and took the bracelet. Unrelated. Dio is now in one of the other pods. Because blood was found on his bracelet, so he is now in a pod. Asleep, unable to get out. And the robot guy that you saw on the ride being all cute, this is his backstory. He tells us all about how he grew up. Him growing up, he didn't, you know, I won't spoil the intricacies of the characters because these characters are fantastic. But we get Kay's backstory here. Quark is there, and Dio is dead. Dio, they just opened the pod and Dio got those doors just closed and we didn't go through them. So we got injected. We're about to die. But before we die, some important stuff gets revealed. Then again, I shan't explain. Right, my passwords before choosing second door, which I believe means I'm going here. That's okay with me. I'm choosing no. I'm going into the green clover. So I'm in this room. I believe it's Clover and Luna. I wish I could speed this bit up. This is long and loud. Oh, we get the extra rolls again. Yeah, that's okay. Hey, everyone meets up. A door's been opened. Take a guess who, and your first guess doesn't count. The kid's ill again. We go through all of this again. I know why they did it, but I am glad that he is the only one you never actually see die. He's the only, everyone else, you see them at least once at some point dead. And he's the only one where that doesn't, he's the only one that doesn't happen. And so Alice ran away like before. She's in the, she's there. We didn't find her, so okay, it's time to go. Time to go back. That is also another game over that you're supposed to get, but it's kind of tied to within itself. I'm choosing the green door here. Takes me into the Golem Bay. Annoyingly, I'm skipping all of the dialogue, but there is one of the a character that you talk to, they have, there's a conversation with after this room that has an amazing accent. Just one of the best voices in the entire game. Damn it. OMG, it's a bunch of robots. Or as that girl from that one mid would say, look at all of those chickens! Thank you. I won't play it, except because it's long. But the dialogue, as I said, there's a dialogue scene here after this room is over. And I recommend people play this game just to get to this room and listen to that dialogue. It's absolutely hilarious. It's this character, this robot character, that they're conversing back and forth with. And after that conversation, a door has been opened. We know where this is going. Tell Fi about that conversation we just had with the robot, and we find Alice dead. Ally with Luna there. I actually don't remember exactly what happened. I know you get a game over if you betray her, but I don't remember why it's a game over if you betray her there. Because it's not as if you, because you don't have enough points to leave even with betraying. The way we have to ally to get to the next part of the story, to get to the next part of this route. And this route, if I was doing any percent, this would be the last one I would. After this route, there are two more character endings left. Is that right? There are two more. One, two, oh, three. I think any percent doesn't do those last three. It goes this one and then goes straight to the end. But Alice was looking for something. She seems to have found it before she died. Fi got inquisitive as to what was found, and now we see that Luna is also dead. This is probably one of my favorite songs in the entire game. is that one? That room's a lot more difficult if you actually try to solve all of the puzzle. If you play that casually, that's one of the more difficult rooms in the game. Okay, so now we're looking at the time-lapse sequence of events that revolve around the time that both of them ended up dying. This is annoying. I was annoying. A lot. Oh no, we have two people dead. Without the context, a lot of this is just me sitting here waiting to get from room to room. But people who've played this game know just how long these bits are that I'm skipping when you don't skip them. Oh, I say that. Anyone who's played Persona 5 also knows what I'm getting at. Someone's been naughty. OMG, Luna's not dead. I don't trust her. We have to trust her. You have anything? Because this is a solid, like, this is another solid 2 minutes of just me sitting here waiting, doing nothing.
2 minutes of the run? How's it going?
Yeah, a lot of the action. It's a lot of it in the early games, like escape room, escape room, escape room. But a lot of the end stuff, because obviously it's where all of the story stuff happens. That's where you have the longer breaks where you don't really do that much. So in this path, I'll explain at least this much. We allied with Luna, and because we allied three times, 3 + 2 + 2 + 2 is equal to 9. We got 9 points. Vi, Sigma, and Quark all escape. But as the number 9 door is about, as the door is about to close, Sigma goes back. So Vi and leaves Quark with Vi because Sigma wants to have this conversation with Luna. There are a lot of very detailed and very story heavy bits explained in this conversation that I don't have time to go into. is the next one I have to do? Oh, next one's PEC. I hate PEC. I wish that one was earlier. If I could route this differently, I would so have PEC at the beginning. I would have PEC right at the beginning. Because it's rubbish. I'm going here. And I'm choosing to go blue. There are some rooms, like for example, the treatment center from earlier. My notes for that room is 3 lines because of how short it is. My notes for this room take up basically the entire page. There's so much going on here. So much of it is required. Leaves, which turns out to be a double-edged sword. Oh! Okay. Reading my own notes is apparently more difficult than it should be. This is why this room is terrible. There's so much of it. There's so much going on. Ah! Nearly done with the room with my least favorite room. Appendix gate has been opened. Blah blah. Again. He's never a nice person. In none of these routes is he even remotely a nice person. Despite the fact that we do only have one point here, and if we get betrayed we die, we actually have to ally here. We have to trust Tetmyoji won't betray us. The reason being that he does trust it. We can trust him, and if we betray him, Clover just leaves and we get a game over. She just buggers off. Could do this one a lot earlier. I think we can anyway, because that piece of information we needed to get past that lock we got right at the beginning. I think there's a second piece that we only get fairly recently, which is why we don't do it. Why we don't do it early? I think I can't remember. anyone watching who has played the first game in this series, who's played 909, there's something in here I think you'll like. You know, if you don't, you don't. I was gonna get one of those wrong eventually, I knew it was. I was never gonna go a whole run without making a single mistake. The gate again as soon as the round ended, and we now get a conversation where we get talked at about termites, which is actually kind of relevant. So despite the fact that both Sigma and Tenmyuji have 8 points, if we ally here and we actually get betrayed, they didn't need to. They could have just allied perfectly fine and had enough points, but... Well, actually no, we don't have 8. Here we do. We have 3. Tenmyuji and Quark have 8. So they didn't need to betray us, but they do it anyway. This is where we found out was dead before. We got a game over because we didn't find her in time, and we now find her in time and save her from herself. process of saving her, because she was wielding a scalpel, we cut ourselves. And it looks like something other than blood on our hands, I will just say that. We have to ally in this one, because if we betray, we get 9. Sigma tries to leave, he doesn't, and they stop him and we get a game over. But in this one, because we ally, we make the decision to choose to stick around, learn more about why the white hand happened. And that information is eventually given to us. We learn some new information about Sigma, and we go boom. I went boom again. This one is after we went into the lab with Dio. We got betrayed because we wanted him to not destroy the medicine. And now we have a way of not getting ourselves killed because we were on negative points. We have a means of saving ourselves. Da-da-da-da-da. That old woman is important. If you know, you know. If you don't, you don't. This is now like the end stretch. This is the final route. Ally here. This is the longest split in the game, I think, but this is the final path. We are not that far from the end. Found more bombs. What are we gonna do? This is a very long conversation that happens in this route about Schrödinger's cat. We find another bomb. We've now found 3. it's an analogy. I'll go Schrödinger's cat, but using the lion, because, again, lions are very important to the story of this game, in ways I won't explain, because I actually want you to play it and understand for yourself. Two down, one to go. We found three bombs, so there's one left. Surprise! There's a fourth bomb! So, fun fact, those four bombs, the first three, you can try as many times as you like to put in random codes. The fourth bomb, you get one attempt. So even if you know the code, if you accidentally input it incorrectly, you have to do it again. You have to watch the scene where you explode, where it explodes, and then you have to start again by inputting the fourth code. This room is really, really complicated. It's not massively complicated, it's just there's a lot going on. It's not actually that, it's... Oh! I did the wrong thing. Shut up. Thank you. Last puzzle of the game. Second. This is like right at the end of the game now. This is like this. I have maybe, 5 minutes left? I've done all the escape rooms. The big escape rooms, I've done all of them. All I've got to do is skip the text for like 5 minutes and then we're done.
Let's go. Text for 5 minutes. I guess that's a premature GG.
This one is the same as the one at the very beginning of the game. And if you do try to do anything other than go straight to the safe and input the code, Fi shouts at you. Dio got kicked. He just got his shit wrecked. And in this path, he's now tied to a sink. He's handcuffed to a sink. And says, everyone, in this path, everybody is alive and everybody has enough points, so everybody gets to leave.
Then, who among us hasn't been tied to a sink, you know?
We all escaped, and now we're all back. Time's coming up real quick.
And
time. So that's... Oh crap, I did a bad... That was not what I wanted. Oh well. 204, 207. It's like 3 minutes behind, but... that's still... It's technically a PB, because the 204 wasn't... I didn't realize at the time it was invalid.
All good.
So that is a bit of a PB then.
That's a dope. Congrats on the PB.
I mean, it's a PB by virtue of being my first valid run, so PB by default.
We take those dopes.
Yeah, I can't skip this either. But if you don't, if you remember back to, I don't know, like an hour and a half ago, and you listen to the credits music is slightly different in this one. It's a lot more triumphant than the last one.
We love alternate credit music.
I think this part of it's the same, but the first part of it was like a more, was like a little remix, like a more triumphant version of like, you've actually reached the end, rather than you've reached an end. Yeah, I'm glad I got to show that off, got to show off how not fantastic I am at escape rooms and all of that. I apologize for not talking very much, but there we go. That's how it is.
Pog. Yeah, GG's. Thank you for the run. Ethaner.
Yeah, if I get even one person watching it right now to play this series, then I will consider, I'll consider this a success.
W.
Yeah, I mean, if you like visual novels, because you mentioned Danganronpa, right?
Yeah, Professor Layton also comes to mind.
Yeah, if you liked those games, you'll very likely enjoy all three of the games in this series. All of them are on Steam.
I'll look into it. Oh, and it's a sale, I think. There's a sale going on Steam.
Oh, that's Pog.
Yeah. All right. W Run from a W Runner.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for being able to showcase this game. Got 110 donated to the Trevor Project. And we'll be coming at you again very soon with our next run. Very soon.
And my final thing before I leave, hashtag trans rights are human rights.
There we go.